Today's game is coming to you live from Looneyapolis, Craziana. We're at Mucus Asylum Stadium, and the inmates are taking their medication along with their seats, sharpening their knives, and hopefully not listening to the voices in their heads. Yeah, this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Brain Washington Cadavers battle the Insane Colts. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full. The familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air. And the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions. Water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hand dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
Second down and a lot. And the QB decides to throw the ball away. Third down and, well, good luck. He runs it for three. No, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two. Flimsy Lohan's nose hits a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
First down and nine.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Four. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. Third down and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Third down and forever.
Hot one, hot two.
That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next?
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not young.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Six-yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and ten. Great throw and a great catch. This guy's a brick sh-
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and ten. Lateral to his teammate, like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10. Third down and the punter is warming up. It's a brutal hit. And it's first and ten. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and seven. I hope you covered your ears, Rich, because first down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and ten. Right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And that'll be second and eight to go. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First and ten. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was on to the races. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. another player will assume the kicking role for the remainder of the game. The coach is praying he won't need a long field goal to win this one. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Unstoppable force meets the explodable object. The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And this game is up for grabs. Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two.
Prison just came out of the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, eight.
He's not going down. Second down and long.
Hot one, hot two.
Stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what if interceptions counted as touchdowns?
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
And it's first and ten. The quarterback said they'd blow up the defense today. He was right. Second down and ten. Excuses for this QB. He zigged when he should have zagged and ends up a shish kebab.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And it's first and ten. Called a zap attack. He was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
can you see that, Grant?
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And it's first and ten. Butter. A gain of eight right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And it's first and ten. Stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So it's...
come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. Second down and 10. Morning. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
And it's first and 10. Tell he's a berserker because he's dropping at the mouth. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. The offense has only two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. First and 10.
First down. Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and 10. And he picks up about six on the play. And that'll be second down and four. Taken with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
First down and six. So they will lose all running plays in their playbook. Second down and six.
Ah, another interception.
Boom! First and 10. for a first down. And it's first and 10. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. The defense calls their first timeout to save some clock.
I save clocks too, Grim. My wife hates them. They take up the whole garage.
Wait, what? You're married?
It's complicated.
That pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get...
And that's 2 timeouts gone for the defense. But they've really got to get the ball back to their offense.
But the offense is like 30 balls over there on the sideline just waiting for them. Why don't they just use them? Ask the ball boy. He didn't do nothing.
Nice punt. Should move them back nicely. And he snags the punt and looks for... Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Another interception. This quarterback is... Oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and 10. It's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
First down and 3. And this, oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers... Well, there's your answer, Bricks.
I know. I hate those zebra men.
When in a hurry, defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
He's at the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, and he runs it in for the touchdown. The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, and that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it.
Yeah.
The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the Halftime Show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Second down and a lot. When the coach said the offense was going to be explosive this week, he meant it literally. Third down and, well, good luck. Toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
First down and six. And with another pick, the QB's pow. And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and ten.
Don't worry. If he shocks you, then...
Oh, he took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble!
He's got a case of fumble-itis!
Well, why go for one when you can go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Well, we're talking about points.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And his back, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and ten. And he was steering a pick six, but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
Second down and ten.
Hot one.
He could go all the way. It's first and 10. This is your brain, and this is your intellect. Breaks his balls. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way.
Say what? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm going to ruin your world. You understand me?
They're going for 2 points. Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. The offense lost their final quarterback. Lucky for them, they're on defense now or the game would be over.
So all the other team has to do is punt to force a forfeit?
That would be correct, Bricks. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, devastating hit! You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and 10.
Not one.
And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
With no one left on their roster, the insane Colts take a brutal loss by forfeit. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every up.